There are different methods that you can use to remove bloatware from your Android device. It all depends on your preference and how you want to do it. Like, some methods require a PC, or most methods require a PC actually, and there are only a few methods that work without a PC. In today's video, we'll take a look at some of the best ways that you can use to remove bloatware from your Android device without rooting it. And we'll see how effective and how user-friendly these methods are. Please make sure to stay till the end because I'm going to show you one excellent method for extreme Android debloating that will remove most of the pre-installed applications from your Android device. So, let's get started. Before you start debloating your Android phone, the first important step is to enable USB debugging through developer options, because that is required for every method you are planning to use. Now let's take a look at all the methods one by one. The first method is known as ADB App Control, and I think this is one of the easiest ways to remove bloatware from your Android device. And I have already made a video about this method, but I just wanted to share this method with you guys again. This method requires a PC and it is very easy to use, because it gives you all the application names present in your device. After deleting the Android bloatware, you can also save the presets that are going to help you the next time you would want to debloat your phone again. You can simply load the preset and start debloating your phone. This method also works wirelessly, so if your phone and PC are connected to the same Wi-Fi network, ADB App Control will help you debloat your phone through the wireless method as well. This method also lets you install the APK files in your phone. Let's say you removed any application like Google Chrome and you want to use a different Android browser. You can just download the APK file of any browser in your PC and install it through the software. ADB App Control is very user-friendly, works with almost every Android phone, and is one of the easiest ways to remove bloatware from your Android device. Well, there are some drawbacks for the software, like you need to install an additional application called as AC Bridge in your phone. And if you are using a Xiaomi device, you need to give some extra permissions. Other than that, this tool is perfect. The second method to remove bloatware from your Android device is through Xiaomi ADB Tools, which is used to manage Xiaomi devices through ADB and Fastboot, but it can work with some other devices as well. Xiaomi ADB Tools is one of the oldest methods to remove bloatware from Xiaomi devices, but it is no longer maintained, so it might not work with the latest Xiaomi devices or latest Android devices. Which leads us to method number 3, known as UAD, or Universal Android Debloater. Universal Android Debloater is one of the best ways to remove bloatware from your Android device, because it gives you the package names of all the applications that are present in your device. Apart from that, you will also find some really useful features like importing and exporting the application list in the text format. And you will also find different well-categorized list of applications to get better information about the applications you would want to remove from your device. One incredible feature present in UAD is that you can connect multiple devices at once. So if you are planning to debloat one or more Android devices, it is definitely going to save you some time. And if you are using an automatic method to remove bloatware from your Android device, there might be instances where the phone might go into boot loop if any important system application is deleted, but that's not very common. But if it happens, your phone will boot loop multiple times, but at the end, it will automatically go to recovery mode, where you can perform a factory reset and you should be good to go after that. Another method to remove bloatware from your Android device is through platform tools using direct commands. If you have the package names of all the applications that you want to remove from your Android device, this method is also good. But it is time consuming because you have to manually type all the commands. If you are planning to debloat your Android phone through this method, you can simply download and extract platform tools in your PC. Open the extracted folder and type cmd in the address bar and press enter to open the command prompt. You can first verify if your device is connected through ADB mode by using the command ADB space devices. When your device is detected by your PC, you can type ADB space shell and then type the commands plus package names to debloat your Android phone. We have seen 4 different methods to remove bloatware from your Android device using a PC. Now, method number 5 is debloating one Android phone using a second Android phone through an application called as ADB-OTG. This application is freely available on Google Play Store and you also need an OTG adapter to make this work. So here we have Redmi Note 10 Pro and Realme 7 Pro, and I'll be removing bloatware from Realme 7 Pro. Step 1 is to download ADB OTG in Redmi Note 10 Pro. Step 2 is to enable USB debugging in Realme 7 Pro. Step number 3 is to connect both the devices, and since I'll be using Redmi Note 10 Pro to debloat Realme 7 Pro, I will insert this adapter in Redmi Note 10 Pro. As soon as you connect the devices, you will get an immediate pop-up about allowing USB debugging, and once that is done, you can start typing the commands directly. There is no need to check if the device is connected through ADB mode or not, you can straight away start typing the commands. I'll place a link in the video description in case you want the list of commands that you can use to debloat your Android phone, so you can go ahead and check it out. Now, coming to the last method I mentioned in the beginning of this video, that is going to remove most of the pre-installed applications from your Android device. And this method requires a PC. To make this work, you have to download a zip file in your PC which contains debloating scripts for different devices. These scripts are bad files that will remove the pre-installed applications with just one click. Let's take a look at step-by-step guide on how this method works. So these are the scripts for the devices like Xiaomi, Oppo, Realme and others. Step number 1 is to rename the files by adding the extension .bat. Let's say you have a Xiaomi device. You will right click on this Xiaomi file here and rename it to Xiaomi.bat. Step number 2 is to check the list of applications that are present in this bat file. You can just right click again and go to edit. Here you will see the package names of all the applications that are included in this bat file. And if you scroll down a bit, you will see this MIUI launcher. So this bat file is going to delete the system launcher as well. And if you don't want that to happen, you can simply select this command and delete it and save the file. And if you are planning to delete the system launcher, please make sure you have any other launcher installed in your phone before you click on this file. Once everything is set, you can connect to your phone and allow all the USB permissions. You can go ahead and double click on this bat file and it is going to remove all the applications that are present in this script. It is better if you run this script twice so that it does not miss any application, and that's it, debloating is done. I'll try to place all the required links in the video description, so please make sure you check the links before you start with any of these methods. And if this is your first time on this channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, stay safe and take care.